reminder what the college football playoff looks like. 1 versus 4 is Clemson, Alabama. 2 versus 3 is Oklahoma, Georgia. And Stanley is shaking his head.
That's terrible.
Because number 5 and number ridiculous. 6 are from his league.
That's just ridiculous.
He doesn't like
it. I'm not happy about that, Mike.
No. Speaking of people wanting changes, here's what Jim Harbaugh said this week about the playoff, or last week, I should say. I would just analyze it in terms of every other sport, whether it's gymnastics, basketball, pro football, FCS football. Pick a sport, and they have a playoff to get to a champion. None of them start with the last 4. You have a great model with the NFL with their 12 teams and a great model in the FCS with their 16 teams, and they just increased it to 24. 8 teams would be better than 4. 12 would be better than 8. I think 16 is kind of the sweet spot. So, with that in mind, we're bringing in Robbie Hummel to be with Stanley Jackson to have this discussion. Any of those ideas he offered, the 2 systems that your sports are most accustomed to, any other thing on the table, what is the best way to determine a champion?
Well, I look at college basketball, and I think you see it. There is no question at the end of the day, the team that wins the NCAA tournament is the best team right now. Now, I think the cool thing about that format is you have upsets, you have teams that if they play maybe 4 or 5 times, they're not going to win in a series, but on any given day, especially in the game of basketball, because it's with the 3-point shot, football to me is more of a physically dominating game. Upsets are less, I guess, common than you would see in college basketball, but I've never questioned at the end of a basketball season in college, was that team the champion? Because they won 5 in a row and they deserved it.
Well, the one thing you said, though, is they're the best team right now.
Right.
Not necessarily the best team in college basketball. And I'm not sure we can get to the perfect format for college football. And I really think when you look at Major League Baseball and the NBA, they've got the perfect format to get the best team.
Yep.
Because through a span of 7 games, right, the best team typically is going to win more, and you don't just get that one upset. But even in the NFL, when those teams match up because the parity is so close, we've had a lot of wild card teams run the table and win it. Mm-hmm. So you can't play multiple games in football, but I do think adding teams in some regard makes sense. Now, I don't know if it makes sense for college football because these players aren't paid. It's a long season. I don't know if you take a game away. And I'm shocked that FCS has gone to 24 teams. But if you ask me, the best format is always playing multiple games between 2 teams to figure out who's the best and then moving on.
So here's the argument for a smaller, right, is Villanova in 85. Was that really the best team? Or was it the best team over a 3-week span?
But to me, they are getting a chance to prove that. You could, in football, you could argue, we didn't get a chance. And if you look at the 90s and the 80s, there's teams that are like, we should have been the national champion, but we were not in the national championship game to win that. In right. college basketball, that is never an argument. I can look at that and say, this team went out and they beat everybody they played. They are the champion. They might not be the best team, but they played the best and they deserve to win.
Well, they beat everybody they played, but the other thing is now seeding as well. I mean, some teams have an easier bracket to get to the championship, and I've watched some teams have to go through really 3 number ones because the bracket seating wasn't the way it should have been. And listen, I don't know what you do in football. I think the best thing for college football is simply this. You do away with the divisions. You play a round robin in your conference. You take the top 2 teams from the Power 5 conferences, and you have a play-in, and then you have one at-large. So now you've got 6 teams in. You get one at-large. You're going to get the very best team from the conferences, and then you let them play it out.
Right.
Having a committee, having people involved, picking this, when you talk about the eye test, when you tell, you know, the country for 3 years that strength of schedule matters, and then all of a sudden, strength of schedule goes out the window. That's the big problem. So just take the best 2 teams from every conference, and then the championship games actually are at the beginning of the playoff.
Yeah. Here's what I know. No matter what happens, no one will be happy. When it was just bowl games, people were furious there wasn't at least a national championship game. When there was a BCS national championship game, people were furious there's not 4. Now that there's 4, people are furious there's not 8. Once you get to 8, people will be furious they're not 16.
That's why you gotta love this country. It's phenomenal. You always gotta get better, Mike. You gotta get better. But how can you argue with the top 2 teams in every conference?